Good morning, I'm Dr. Al Ogeron with the LSU Ag Center. I do the sugarcane weed control work for the Ag Center. We're gonna talk a little bit about this being an opportune time to control some of our major weed pests in cane. Sugarcane is a perennial plant and we don't have a whole lot of opportunity to do cultivation to the top of this planted seed bed. And weeds become establishing and it makes it a really difficult situation to control. Some of our major weed problems are Bermuda grass, Johnson grass, Nut Sedge, and these are all perennial weeds. So their growth habit, along with cane being a perennial, makes it really challenging to control. There are very few options to take these weeds out once they become established in the crop. And the fallow period is the ideal time to try to manage these weed pests. It's where we make our largest strides, and it's really the foundation of our weed management program. So there are a couple different approaches that you can take when managing weeds in fallow land. One is very traditional methods. It's cultivation followed up with glyphosate application. And it's important, and especially when we get into Bermuda grass situations, that we do multiple cultivation events followed by multiple glyphosate events. Now, when you spray glyphosate on the cane for you, you want to wait at least 10 days, 7 to 10 days before you do any cultivation to give time for that herbicide to translocate, to move throughout that plant, and to get in the stolons and the rhizomes of Bermuda grass. So in this field, we have another one of our many weed pests is purple nut sedge. Glyphosate does a great job on most of our grass weeds, but one of the weeds it often misses is this purple nut sedge. And to deal with this pest, we often recommend we tank mix something like halosulfuron, which would be permit, with glyphosate to manage this weed pest. It does a better job. Now, we want to do this on our first application of glyphosate, typically in June, but we also can do it in July. But it'll give us a much better efficacy when we come to try to control this problematic pest. Glyphosate tolerant soybeans are a great option for fallow field production as well. What this really does is gives us an option to control pests like Johnson grass and itch grass. Those are very easily controlled with glyphosate, and we do a really nice job with that. Now, weeds like Bermuda grass and nut sedge are a little bit tougher to control in these situations. But one of the great things about having soybeans on fallow land, it gives you a little cash flow if we harvest these beans. Another great point about growing soybeans on fallow ground, it protects the soil. You know, soil conservation is a very important thing that we have to be concerned with. We get a lot of erosion events when we get heavy downpours during the summertime. So having a cover crop on fallow ground is just another way of managing weeds and preventing soil loss. It's always nice when we get new products labeled for use in sugarcane, especially herbicides. And fortunately this year we had three new herbicide products labeled. Strelis 2, Visor S-Mach 2, and Visor S-Mach. Now all three products have the same active ingredient, S-metolachlor. Now we don't have a label with this product alone. All three of these products have received supplemental sugarcane use labels. You may have noticed the Roman numeral 2 behind the name of a couple of these products. What does the Roman numeral 2 signify? Simply, another molecule has been added to the S-metolachlor product to safeguard its use in corn. This is not important in cane, but very important in corn. Lumax EZ also contains S-metolachlor, but it also has atrazine and mesotrione. And we don't always need those chemicals to control some of the weed issues. Where this product's gonna fit really nice is in terms of where we have problems with ryegrass. These S-metolachlor products provide excellent ryegrass control for a very relatively cost-effective price. They may have other options for other weeds to manage with these products, and we're on the way investigating these products.